Module number 2. In this module, we will be discuss about the shape of periodic table. To understand shape of periodic table, we will be discuss here periodic table number 1, number 2, groups and periods in the periodic table, number 3, blocks in the periodic table and their position in the periodic table. Observe the diagram. You can understand the shape of periodic table. Elements are arranged in their increasing atomic number. So if any element we are going to write the electronic configuration, we observe that valence shell electronic configuration will end at any one of subshell. If subshell is S, it will be placed in S block element. If subshell is valence shell ends as a subshell P, it will be placed at P block element. And if subshell, valence subshell is end at the D, it will be considered as a D block element. And if valence shell ends as a F subshell, it will be considered as a F block element. So we can say that there are four blocks in the periodic table. And first, if we consider the observe the left side of the periodic table, we observe first two column is S block element, then 1B to 8B are the D block element. Then as you move from left to right, we observe that at the right side, six vertical column are considered as a P block element. At the bottom, we observe the F block element, and we observe two rows, that is 4F lanthanide series and 5F, that is actinide series. Now, periods periodic table. Observe the diagram. You observe that the number of valence electron or outer shell electron is considered as a group number, and shell number is considered as a period number. The periodic table, also known as the periodic table of element, it is a tabular display of elements which are arranged by atomic number, electron configuration, and their chemical properties. Therefore, we can say that a table showing systematic arrangement of elements according to their increasing atomic number, in which their properties are repeated in periodic manner, called periodic table. First element will be placed here, hydrogen, then helium. First shell is completed. Then second shell start, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, chlorine, and neon. Then second shell complete, up to eight element, and maximum capacity of second shell is 8. Then third shell is begin, and so on. So we can say that the groups and period can be defined as the vertical column on the periodic table are called groups of families. Groups probably come in most handy when predicting the properties of element. The groups are numbered from 1 to 18, from the left to right, and some of the groups have a special name. 1 and 2 are S block element, that is 1A and 2A. 1A is considered as the alkali metal, and 2A will be considered as the alkaline earth metal. 3 to 13 will be the D block element, then 14 to 18 are P block element, which is considered as the 3A to 8A. 3A, 4A, 5A, 6A do not having a specified name. Their first member of the family will be considered as the their name. For example, boron family, carbon family, nitrogen family, and oxygen family. And then number 7, group 7A is considered as the halogen, and 8A considered as the noble gases. Now, period. A period is the horizontal row of the periodic table. There are 7 periods in the periodic table, with each one beginning at the far left. A new period begins when a new principal energy level or shell begin filling with electron. Period 1 has only 2 elements, hydrogen and helium, while period 2 and 3 have 8 elements. Period 4 and 5 have having 18 elements. Period 6 and 7 have 32 elements, because that two bottom rows are that are separated from the rest of the tables belong to those periods. First three periods are called short period, and remaining periods are called long period. Observe the diagram. horizontal rows are considered as the period. Vertical columns are considered as the group. And S1, it is the way to write the balance sheet configuration. N is considered as a period number. At the center, S, T, G, or F will be showing the block. It will be a small letter, and there's four blocks, S block, P block, D block, and F block. And at the upper, and in the form of a superscript, number of electron will be mentioned, which will be considered as the group number. So we can see the number of valence electron in the atom determine the group number of that atom. Blocks in the periodic table and their position in the periodic table. Observe the diagram. We already discussed S block element are present at the left side corner of the periodic table, P block element present at the right corner of the periodic table, D block element present between the S and P block, and at the bottom we observe the F block element. So S block element group 1A and 2A are the S block element, they are all metal. P block element are 3A to 8A, and they all are the non-metals, non-metal, and metallite. There are three categories of each, right? Metals are present over there, non-metal, and in between we observe the metallite. D block element also considered the outer transition element, which is starting from 1B to 8B. And F block element are considered as an inner transition element having two series, lanthanide 4F series and actinide 5F series. Okay, thank you. It is up to the module number 2. Thank you.